This is a breading station, flour, egg, breadcrumb. And with the egg, of course, you beat the egg and add a little bit of milk. Okay, into this panko breadcrumbs here, we're going to add a little bit of Herbes de Provence. Okay, like this. Toss it together. And this is a proper breading station for fish, chicken, or other foods. Okay, these are farm-raised sea bass fillets. We're going to cut them into smaller portions so they'll cook a little more evenly. And we're gonna run them through the breading station. Okay, I prefer a latex glove when I do breading. It just keeps your hand a little nicer and keeps the breading on the product instead of on your fingers. So just flour these like this. After the flour, you go to the egg. And after the egg, you go to the breadcrumbs. In this case, it's panko with Herbes de Provence. Okay. And right here is the finished panko breaded sea bass. Okay. Looking good. Okay, the breaded fish ready for pan frying. Okay, when you pan fry, you want to have a small amount of oil, maybe half an inch to 1 inch depth. And this is 50% vegetable oil, 50% olive oil, better flavor. You select your larger pieces first, like these right here, and you put them down very carefully. A little rule of thumb here for you newbies, fish should only be turned once. So this, after it's partially cooked, is gonna go in the oven for just a little bit, okay? Let this simmer, I'll be back. This oil, by the way, was at 350 degrees and it has dropped down to about 250 pretty quickly. Okay, one of my favorite tools is this fish spatula. I love these things. It's got a slight offset shape. The main thing is when you're ready to turn something like fish, the oil stays in the pan and not all over the place. It's also a lot easier to clean. And of course, these are in stock at your sponsor there. You very carefully flip the fish over. I like to use a couple fingers. There you go, perfectly cooked breaded fish. You can see how much easier it is by using the right tools. Fish spatula, awesome. Very, very little oil coming out of the pan. A couple drops. Okay, this fish is now ready to go to a sheet pan. We're gonna drain it on paper towels here. And then once it drains, it's gonna stay hot in the oven until we're ready to plate it. Serve it up. Okay, once again, you see how little oil is actually on my tray. The oil's in the pan. I'll be back. I prefer this brand of panko because it's very light and fluffy and great for coating seafood especially. Good stuff.